Is that kind of order? Senators will be in their seats and the clerk will call the board.
Alley. Baumgartner. Berger. Billinger. Boyan. Bowers. Denny. Dahl. Estes. Fausto. Fitzgerald. Francisco. Givens. Goddard. Haley. Hardy. Hawk. Hensley. Hildebrand. Holland. Kelly. Kirschen. Longbine. Lynn. Masterson. McGinn. Olson. Peterson. Petty. Pilcher Cook. Pyle. Rogers. Schmidt. Scoobal. Sonnentrop. Sykes. Taylor. Tyson. Wago. Wilborn.
Senators and their guests, please rise and give prayer of attention to our Senate Chaplain, Pastor Washington.
Please bow with me. Heavenly Father, this month of February, recognized as Black History Month, has been selected to acknowledge contributions coming from the Black community that have been and are a blessing to this nation. Lord, we're told that the month of February was selected to coincide with the birthdays of Frederick Douglass and Abraham Lincoln. And Lord, you have us standing today on the shoulders of these two men, along with many others, who worked together guiding this nation in its quest for freedom and stability. In your providence, you led Douglass to become one of the most powerful leaders in the anti-slavery movement and to work as an advisor to Abraham Lincoln during the Civil War, and later to become one of the first African-American citizens to hold a government position. Lord, you've made it clear in your word in Psalms 127, verse 1, and history has verified that unless you are governing and guiding, the labor of this house is in vain. I pray, therefore, that for the purposes of strengthening the freedoms and civility in this land, that you will look down on these hallowed halls and give us guidance. You are our rock of stability. Keep us leaning and depending on you. In the name of Christ Jesus, amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
On a point of personal privilege, the chair recognizes the Senator from Centric, Senator Kirschen.
Thank you, Madam President. I am really excited to announce that right before noon today, we have a new grandson, Otis Howard, and he's 7 pounds, 11 ounces, and he's doing fine.
On a point of personal privilege, the chair recognizes the Senator from Centric, Senator Rogers.
Thank you, Madam President. I would like to recognize a constituent of the 25th Senate District. She happens to be standing behind me, my wife, Chris Rogers. She was named the Greater Wichita YMCA Volunteer of the Year. So I'm very proud of her and her work. It's a little self-interest in my part, of course, but I just wanted to know, let everyone to know that. The YMCA in Wichita had over 5 million visits last year. They're also located in El Dorado and Newton now. It's a great organization, and just wanted you to understand and recognize it for that. So thank you very much.
Is to recess for a caucus. Are there announcements? Senator Cedric, Senator Peterson.
Just wanted to announce for soccer fans, there will be a watch party tonight at 8 p.m. at Watkins Center. That's 925 Kansas here on the south side of the Four First Building. Thank you.
Seeing no more announcements, the chair recognizes the majority leader from Johnson County, Senator Dave.
Thank you, Madam President. Upon recess, Senate Republicans will caucus in our normal room, 548 South.
You've heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. We are recess. Oh, okay. Before we go back to the majority, the chair recognizes the Senator from North Douglas, Senator Francisco.
Thank you, Madam President. The Senate Democrats will be using the same time upon recess to caucus in our standard room 287.
Senator Johnson, majority of your day.
Thank you, Madam President. I move the Senate recess to the sound of the gavel.
You've heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. We are at recess.
I'm actually going to stop the camera this time.
What's that?
I'm going to stop the camera this time.
Yeah.
Because last time it almost died. Yeah.
Introduction of bills and concurrent resolutions. The clerk will read.
Senate Bill 378 by Senator Berger, an act concerning crimes, punishment, and criminal procedure. Senate Bill 379 by 2017 Special Committee on Natural Resources, an act concerning water. Senate Bill 380 by Committee on Judiciary, an act concerning pawnbrokers and precious metal dealers. Senate Bill 381 by Committee on Judiciary, an act concerning the Kansas Recreational Trails Act. Senate Bill 382 by Committee on Judiciary, an act concerning crimes, punishment, and criminal procedure. Senate Bill 383 by Committee on Judiciary, an act concerning crimes, punishment, and criminal procedure. Senate Bill 384 by Committee on Judiciary, an act concerning the Kansas Criminal Justice Coordinating Council. Senate Bill 385 by Committee on Utilities, an act concerning the State Corporation Commission. Senate Bill 386 by Committee on Public Health and Welfare, an act concerning the Behavioral Sciences Regulatory Board. Senate Bill 387 by Committee on Public Health and Welfare, an act concerning health and healthcare. Senate Bill 388 by Senator Hardy, an act concerning the judicial branch. Senate Bill 389 by Committee on Ways and Means, an act concerning children and minors. Senate Bill 390 by Senator Royan, enacting the Extreme Risk Order Act. Senate Bill 391 by Committee on Transportation, an act regulating traffic.
This constitutes the introduction of Senate Bill 378 through Senate Bill 391. Please note reference of bills on pages 1 through 3 of the calendar. introduction of original motions and Senate resolutions of clerk will read.
Senate Resolution 1765 by Senator Baumgartner, a resolution congratulating and commending the individuals selected as award-winning educators in Kansas.
Chair recognizes the Senator from Miami County, Senator Baumgartner.
Thank you, Madam President. Resolution 1765 is designed to recognize 55 educators throughout the state of Kansas. They will actually all be coming to Topeka on Friday. One of them, Heidi Albin, is an educator in Mays School District, that's USD 266, and she is being recognized as the recipient of the 2007 Milken Educator Award. She is the only recipient for this state. We also have 22 educators at both the elementary, middle, and high school level that are receiving National Board Certification, which is a voluntary process, and it's achieved through performance-based assessments where the teacher is videotaped and evaluated and is identified as achieving the highest and most rigorous standards in the classroom. And last but not least is one of my favorite, and that is the Horizon Award. We have 32 educators from the elementary, middle, and high school that are recognized for their outstanding achievement in their first year of teaching. So they just are midway through their second year of teaching, and those are our Horizon Award winners. And so I do at this time move an emergency be declared and rule suspended, and Senate Resolution 1765 be adopted by voice vote.
You've heard the motion. All those in favor say aye. Opposed, nay. Motion carries. The chair recognizes the majority leader in Johnson County, Senator Denny.
Thank you, Madam President. I move the Senate resolve itself into the Committee of the Whole for consideration of bills on the calendar under the heading of General Orders.
You've heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. The chair appoints the Senator from Central County, Senator Kirshen, to preside over the Committee of the Whole.
That pornography is used as a gateway to sex trafficking.
that sexually exploited women and children are often used for the production of pornography without their consent, and some victims are trafficked specifically for the use and production of pornography. According to the National Center on Sexual Exploitation, traffickers show pornography to sex trafficking victims to train them and desensitize them to sex acts that they will be forced to perform. The internet makes the distribution of consumption and consumption of pornography very easy. Webcams, digital cameras, and smartphones can all be used as tools to produce access and trade images. Representative Dr. Abe Buffy, a radiologist, testified about the scientific data regarding the impact of pornography on the brain and neurodevelopment. Neurobiology related to pornography and addiction is complex, but there is a developing understanding of neuroplasticity in the hardwiring of the brain regions related to rewards and pleasure pathways. The evidence increasingly supports the description of compulsive sexual behaviors as an addiction, recently described in a paper titled, which I won't go into the title, if anybody wants to know, they can come up and ask me, but it was published in the journal Socioaffective Neuroscience and Psychology. Drugs of abuse and behavioral rewards such as pornography have the same molecular and cellular mechanisms that control vulnerability to addiction as described in the Journal of Neuroscience. Importantly, there is a significant negative association between pornography use and gray matter volume in certain portions of the brain. In addition to the anatomical differences which can be seen in an MRI, functional activity and functional connectivity are also negatively associated with pornography consumption. These findings were described in a JAMA psychiatry article. During childhood and adolescence, there's a tremendous amount of neurodevelopment. During these years, the hardwiring of the brain is being established. The effect of pornography on the neural development of children is particularly concerning. There's a significant effect of exposure to media on adolescents' attitudes and perceptions found and described in the study published in Adolescent Medicine. Sexting behaviors have been found to be significantly associated with consumption of pornography. Sexually explicit movies have been found to be significantly related to beliefs that women are sex objects. Those findings were described in a study called Adolescents' Exposure to Sexualized Media Environment and Their Notions of Women as Sex Objects. Now, Todd Bowman, also gave testimony. He's an educator and the author of the nation's only accredited sexual addiction treatment provider certificate program for licensed mental health practitioners. And he gives a very important quote that goes to the nut of this resolution. Quote, to prevent unprecedented emotional, psychological, and physical damage to generations born in the digital age, we must first recognize pornography as a public health crisis, and then respond with skillfully prepared and executed intervention. Now, in the work on the social cost of pornography,
Discipline Institute in Washington, D.C., cites that high pornography users were found to score higher on 1, acceptance of the rape and meth, 2, acceptance of violence towards women, 3, adversarial sex beliefs, 4, reported likelihood of committing rape, 5, forced sex acts, and 6, sexual callousness. There are neurobiological changes associated with pornography consumption that underlie these attitudes, especially true in the developmental process of young men and women, who, according to Covenant Eyes, from ages 12 to 17, comprise the largest demographic of internet pornography users. The sexual imaginations of young people are often filled with scenes of abuse, humiliation, violence, and rape. Our collective disdain for rape culture should serve as a compelling rationale for identifying pornography as a public health crisis. Prolonged pornography viewing over time leads to 4 notable brain-related changes, as discussed by author Peter Wilson: desensitization, sensitization, hypofrontality, and dysfunctional. Desensitization can be understood as a numbed response to pleasure. The second brain-related change, sensitization, can be defined as an unconscious supermemory of pleasure that, when activated, triggers powerful cravings. Hypofrontality, the third brain-related change, is best understood as reduced brain activity in the prefrontal regions, which weakens willpower in the face of strong subconscious cravings. The final brain-related change, according to Wilson, leads to dysfunctional stress circuits, which can make even minor stress lead to cravings and relapse because they activate powerful sensitized pathways. I will stand for questions.
Thank you. Any questions for the Senator from Johnson on the resolution? Seeing none, Senator, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Science is showing us how harmful pornography is to the individual's health. It is also harmful to the public health of the community. Everyone, in some way, is affected by increased pornography use in society. We all suffer negative consequences from its distorted view of the human person and sexuality. There are many tears shed in the community hearing when personal stories were given. Pornography hurts the user by diminishing the capacity for healthy human relationships. As I stated earlier, it's a distorted view of human sexuality, contrary to authentic love. And because of that, it harms a person's sense of self-worth. Our bodies have a beautiful meaning and dignity and should be treated with the greatest respect. Our bodies are not meant to be used, but loved. The opposite of love is using a person as if he or she were an object. But to love others is to recognize them as the gift they are as human beings, to seek what is truly good and best for them, and never to use them and objectify them as something less than persons. Pornography breaks down trust between family members, and it damages the ability of parents and other adults to be virtuous role models for children. We've seen the corrosive damage caused by pornography. Children whose innocence is stolen. Men and women who feel great guilt and shame for viewing pornography habitually. Spouses who feel betrayed and traumatized. And men, women, and children exploited by the pornography industry. There is no political ideology here regarding this subject, because it is the reality of by the differences and mutual dependencies of men and women. Pornography exploits and humiliates those being used, and it dehumanizes the user at the same time. Pornography is creating a public health crisis and perpetuates a sexually toxic environment. I urge your vote for this resolution, and I move that when the committee rises and reports, it reports Senate Resolution 1762 favorably for passage.
You've heard the motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Now turn our attention to Senate Bill 284. Chair recognizes Senator from Vermont and Senator Longline to explain the bill and ask for the committee report. Adopt the committee report.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move we adopt the committee report.
You've heard the motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Senate Bill 284 would make changes to the Kansas Money Transmitter Act. It would provide rules and regulations. The bill would specify that the state banking commissioner is allowed to issue an order or after notice and an opportunity for a hearing to address violations of the rules and regulations adopted pursuant to the Kansas Money Transmitter Act. It would allow the commissioner to enter into informal agreements at any time with a person to resolve a matter arising under the KMTA rules and regulations adopted pursuant to the KMTA or an order issued pursuant to KMTA. It was described to the committee in testimony by the State Banking Commissioner's Office that this informal agreements would be used on the most minor of violations instead of entering into the full procedure that they do for major violations. The bill would also allow the commissioner to designate people in their office to administer, interpret, and enforce the KMTA. There was a technical amendment related to a statute number that was adopted by the committee. There was no neutral or opponent testimony to the to Senate Bill 284, and I'd be happy to stand for questions.
Are there any questions for the Senator from Hawaii? Seeing none, Senator, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move that when the committee rises and report, it reports Senate Bill 284 favorably for passage.
You've heard the motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? No. Motion carries. We now turn our attention to Senate Bill 283. Chair recognizes Senator from Lyons, Senator Longline, to explain the bill.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Senate Bill 283 would amend several sections of the state banking code. First change in section one would be a change in terminology from common trust to collective investment funds. It was explained to the committee in testimony that collective investment funds is a more appropriate term in today's environment. Section two, notification for acquiring control or change of control of a bank. The bill would specify that a person acting directly, indirectly, or directly or indirectly in concert with one or more persons is prohibited from engaging in any activity that may result or does result in acquiring control of any bank holding company, or trust company without notifying the commissioner at least 30 days in advance prior to acquiring control. Section three provides a waiver of notice requirement that would allow or would require the amendment that a person proposing to acquire control of a bank or trust company undertaking a merger transaction submit an application 60 days prior to the proposed change. The bill would permit the commissioner to waive the 60-day prior notice requirement if the acquired bank or trust company is under formal corrective action. Section four outlines the qualifications of the deputy commissioner of the banking division. The bill was brought to us by the State Banking Commissioner's Office. There was no neutral or opponent testimony, and I'm happy to stand for questions.
Are there any questions for the Senator from Maya on the bill? Not seeing any, Senator, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move that when the committee rises and report, it reports Senate Bill 283 favorably for passage.
You've heard the motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carried. We now turn our attention to Senate Bill 292. The chair recognizes Senator from Lyon to explain the bill.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Senate Bill 292 would amend law relating to the expulsion of credit union members. The bill would authorize the credit union employee designated by the Board of Directors to expel a credit union member from the credit union under certain circumstances. The bill would specify a member could be expelled for failure to comply with the credit union's adopted policy regarding expulsion. The bill would require the president or the general manager to report such expulsion at the next regularly scheduled board meeting. Additionally, the bill would eliminate the requirement that the Board of Directors provide notice to the member not less than 30 days to the effective date of the expulsion. The bill would instead require the expelled member to be informed of the reason for the expulsion. The expelled member would be permitted to appeal the expulsion to the Board of Directors within 30 days. This was brought to us by the Heartland Credit Union Association, and the Kansas Department of Credit Unions testified in support. There was no opposition and no neutral testimony. Be happy to stand for questions.
Are there any questions for the Senator from Hawaii? Not seeing any Senator, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move that when the committee rises and reports, it reports Senate Bill 292 favorably for passage.
You heard the motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. Next, turn our attention to Senate Bill 335. Again, we call on the Senator from Lyon, Senator Longline, to explain the bill and adopt the committee report.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move we adopt the committee report.
You heard the motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. You may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Senate Bill 335, the modernization of the savings and loan and savings bank and the merger into the state banking code. New Section 1 defines the activities of mutual state banks and how they might be organized. New Section 5 is definitions on an investment capital stock and also defines what savings and loan service corporation or service corporations, a corporation or limited liability organized under Kansas law. It gets those definitions. New Section 2 outlines the investment in a service corporation by a savings and loan or savings bank, and that investment would not exceed 3% of the association's assets. New Section 3 also defines the application and loan association, defines the application required to the commissioner's office. New Section 4 defines the activities of a service corporation. New Section 6 allows for a certificate of existence, which is basically an authorization for someone in a small business or an LLC to act on behalf of the owner in opening up a deposit account, a loan account, or other banking loan relationship. Section 7 is State Bank Code definitions. Would provide the following definitions to state banking code. It defines what a stock bank is, a mutual state bank, and a savings and loan association. Section 8 gives provisions for conversion to a state bank. Section 9, conversion to a national bank. And then sections 10 through 20 outline the capital requirements. Sections 22 through 25 are internal references. The bill was brought to us by the Kansas Bankers Association. The State Banking Commissioner's Office offered testimony in support. There were no neutral or opponent testimony provided to the committee. With that, I'd be happy to stand for questions.
Are there any questions for the Senator from Lyon? Senator from Riley, Senator Hall.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I have a strange question for the carrier of the bill, if I might.
You may.
On page 41 of the bill, it talks about TANF and some of the procedures that DCF does, and I'm sure there's a good reason. I see there's been some changes on page 40, line 17 in section 8, saying placement under the revised Kansas Code for the Care of Children or revised Kansas Juvenile Justice Code. So my question is, why is that in a banking bill?
It's my understanding from the reviser that there were references to TANF in the old savings and loan legislation for some reason, way back from 1943 when they were first adopted, and for her to properly repeal this. It had to be listed in this. So this is actually a repeal of the items that you were questioning.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate getting that information.
Are there any other questions for the Senator from Lyons? Senator from Douglas, Senator Francisco.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. So I noticed that one of the definitions you're changing is with regard to a stock bank, which is a bank that has an ownership structure represented by stock. And then it talks about a federal savings association, and this is on B, also on page 10, or federal savings bank operating in a mutual form and which seeks to become a stock bank must also convert to stock form prior to converting to a state bank. So is there a difference between a state bank or a stock bank, or is this saying a stock bank is one form of the state bank?
Better from why?
I think the section that the question pertains to is we are making provisions for a stock chartered bank to become a federal or a state chartered bank.
Senator from Douglas?
Thank you. So there is, so a stock bank is also a state bank, and that's why you say you convert to stock, a stock, before you convert to the state bank.
I believe that is correct.
Thank you.
Any other questions for the Senator from Lyon? Seeing none, Senator, you may close.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move that when the committee rises to report it, report Senate Bill 335 favorably for passage.
You've heard the motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. We now turn our attention to Senate Bill 256. We call on the Senator from Finney County, Senator Dahl, to explain the bill.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And before I explain the bill, I want to thank leadership, especially the Chairman of Transportation and Minority Leader for cooperating and helping and guiding me through this bill. This bill deals with, first of all, it's going to change, there's Highway 50, and from Dodge City to Emporia, Highway 50 is called the Turkish Wheat, Red Wheat Highway. What I want to do, well, we're going to, what this statute would do, would take 6 miles of that road, and it would rename it, there was a, by a little town, Bright, Kansas. Bright, Kansas is, has about 200 people in it. They don't have a cop. Everybody knows everybody. Everybody knows everybody's dog. In July of 1970, July 2nd, a guy by the name of Private First Class Richard Conrad was killed in Vietnam. You know, the Senator from Leavenworth has helped me with this, you know, trying to understand the protocol. Sergeant Stein was also located in Vietnam. I guess the normal protocol, and this was what the rumor we were told, was that Sergeant Stein would accompany the body home. Unfortunately, Sergeant Stein was in a hospital in Saigon with shrapnel wounds, so he wasn't able to come home. And on July 30th, the same month, in this little town, Sergeant Stein was killed in a battle. Let's go back to Richie Conrad first. Richie was, his unit was overran. He saw a soldier in distress. He went to help him and was mortally wounded. When he went to help him, for that he received a Silver Star. Sergeant Steinle platoon came on a heavily entrenched enemy. The initial battle, 40% of Greg's company was either killed or wounded. Greg, with his machine gun, started firing, kept firing, got wounded. While he was firing, they were able to take back the wounded and dead. break, they said, probably could have left the jungle, but instead, he saw a bunch of small arms and such laying on the ground, so he went and picked those up, got it back to his platoon. He was wounded again and died. So kind of side note, Greg's dad was standing outside when the soldiers were stopped at the rectory, you know, and right, you see everything everywhere. He saw the soldiers pointing at Steiner's house, and Al ran inside, trying to avoid the obvious, but, you know, soon there was a knock on the door. What this bill would do is name 6 miles of the highway, Chuck's great oldest brother. Well, if Nick's oldest brother, Greg's the oldest, then Chuck. I said, Chuck, I want to name a highway after 6 miles of this highway after your brother. And there was silence, and then Chuck said, can you get Richie on the bill? You know, that's how the Steiner family is. So I said, I certainly try. So, I guess that explains it. What we want to do is we want to put an amendment on it. The spinal mother is not long for this world. She's 92 years old. And my goal, kind of, and this is where leadership has really worked with me, is to get this so the mother can see it before she passes. So we're going to put an amendment. I'd like to put an amendment on and move on page 1, line 22, by striking statute book and inserting the case.
Can you turn the amendment in?
I turned it in, yes, so I'm sorry.
So do you want to explain or have it read?
Well, I'm not reading it right now.
That's why I'm not. Sounds like you want to explain.
I'm sorry. I moved to amend 256, page 1, line 22, by striking statute book and inserting Kansas Register.
Did anybody want to see the amendment written? We have some in case you need it. Any questions on the amendment? Seeing none, whatever you may move your amendment.
I move my amendment.
All in favor of the amendment, see by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Amendment is adopted. Are there any questions on the bill as amended? Any questions at all? Seeing none, Senator, you may close.
I close. Thank you.
You've heard me make the motion.
Oh, yeah.
It's all shut. I move when the committee rises, reports, and reports Senate Bill 256 favorably as for passage.
As amended.
As amended.
You've heard the motion. You can't blame Scoobal for that. To the motion, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
And opposed, same time. Motion. Bill, motion. Amendments passed. Chair recognizes majority from Johnson County, Senator Payne.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I move the committee rise and report.
You heard the motion, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carried.
Senate Resolution 1762 be passed. Senate Bill 284 be amended by the adoption of the committee amendments, and the bill be passed as amended. Senate Bill 283 be passed. Senate Bill 292 be passed. Senate Bill 335 be amended by the adoption of the committee amendments, and the bill be passed as amended. Senate Bill 256 be amended on motion on Senator Dahl, and the bill be passed as amended.
Chair recognizes the Senator from Sedgwick County, Senator Christian, to adopt the committee report.
I move to adopt the committee report.
You've heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed nay. Motion carries. Chair recognizes the Majority Leader from Johnson County, Senator Dillon.
Thank you, Madam President. I move an emergency be declared, the rules suspended, and the following bills and resolution be advanced to final action and roll call. Senate Resolution 1762, Senate Bill 284, Senate Bill 283, Senate Bill 292, Senate Bill 335, and Senate Bill 256.
You've heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed nay. Motion carries. We are now ready for final action. On this roll call, we will take the following. The resolution on page 4, Senate Resolution 1762, and the bills on page 4 through 6, Senate Bill 284, Senate Bill 283, Senate Bill 292, Senate Bill 335, and Senate Bill 256. The clerk will read the titles.
Senate Resolution 1762, a resolution recognizing that pornography is a public health hazard that leads to a broad spectrum of individual and public health impacts and societal harms. Senate Bill 284, an act concerning financial institutions. Senate Bill 283, an act concerning the regulation of financial institutions. Senate Bill 292, an act concerning financial institutions. Senate Bill 335, an act concerning financial institutions. Senate Bill 256, an act designating a portion of the United States Highway 50 as a SGT Rec Steinmal and PFC Richard Carnegie Memorial Highway.
The clerk will call the roll.
Alley. Baumgartner.
Aye.
Berger.
Aye.
Dillinger.
Aye.
Boyer.
Bill 1762, aye on the ballot.
Bowers.
Aye.
Denny.
Aye.
Dahl.
Aye.
Estes.
Aye.
Bascado.
Aye.
Fitzgerald.
No.
Francisco. Giddens. Goddard. Haley.
Senator Fernando.
Thank you, Madam President. I vote no on Senate Resolution 1762 and aye on the remainder. I'd like to explain my no vote on the resolution.
You may proceed.
Thank you, Madam President. No, I vote no on Senate Resolution 1762, striving to affirm, quote, pornography is a public health hazard that leads to a broad spectrum of individual and public health impacts and societal harms, unquote, for two basic reasons, both of which I speak to now and in print in the journal, to mitigate any negative postcards that are once in a future opponent might consider sending. Madam President, primarily I've always held the constitutionality of the First Amendment, including freedom of speech and expression, to be held sacrosanct, most especially where such speech or conduct is privately held between consenting, mentally sound adults. Secondly, in my opinion, it is inaccurate and misleading to consider, quote, pornography in terms of a, quote, public health, unquote, issue. Even though just a resolution, the danger in this language being affirmed by the majority in this chamber, maybe across the way, I fear could lead to unintended consequences in many ways, maybe even including state funding. Most importantly, though, I do believe that pornography is rampant and that society is better served to minimize its existence, especially on public sources such as the internet,
and to more vigorously protect our citizenry, we should prosecute any example where predatorily generated pornography is against a child, or the mentally infirm, or under any economic servitude or economic duress. I would appreciate it if my remarks be spread.
So ordered.
Hardy.
Aye.
Hawk.
Aye.
Hensley.
Aye.
Hildebrand.
No one carried for iron down.
Hollow.
Aye.
Kelly. Kirshen.
Aye.
Longbine.
Aye.
Lynn.
Aye.
Masterson. McGinn.
Aye.
Olson.
Aye.
Peterson.
Aye.
Petty. Pilcher Cook. Pyle. Rogers.
Aye.
Schmidt.
Aye.
Scoogle.
L1762, out of balance.
Sullivan Trout.
Aye.
Sykes.
Aye.
Taylor. Tyson.
Aye.
Wagle. Wilbur.
Has every senator had an opportunity to vote? Senator from Brown County, Senator Podkin. Does any senator wish to change their vote? Does any senator desire to explain their vote? Senator from Wyandotte, Senator Pitt.
I'd like to join Senator Hayden's remarks.
He's approved. Further explanations, Senator from Johnson, Senator Boyer.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'd like to join the remarks of Senator Hayden.
He's agreed. Senator from Johnson, Senator Scubo.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'd like to join the remarks of Senator Bailey also.
So approved. Further changes of vote, further explanation of vote. Seeing none, the clerk will close the roll and tally the vote. Senate Resolution 1762, and 34 having voted for and 5 opposed to Senate Bill 284, all having received the required constitutional majority, are hereby declared passed. Correction, approval of journal. Reports from standing committees, the clerk will read.
Madam President, the Committee of Transportation recommends Senate Bill 291 be passed. Senator Peterson, Chairperson. Madam President, the Committee on Transportation recommends Senate Bill 294 be passed. Senator Peterson, Chairperson.
Messages from the Governor, the clerk will read.
Message to the State of Senate of the State of Kansas, enclosed herewith as Executive Order Number 1804, for your information, with warm regards. Jeff Collier, Governor of the State of Kansas.
Okay. We will now refer back to that order of business, introduction of bills and concurrent resolutions, and the clerk will read.
Announcing adoption of House Concurrent Resolutions Bill. Senate Bill 392 by Senators Pilcher, Cook, and others, an act concerning the legislature relating to bills introduced by committees. Senate Bill 393 by Senators Pilcher, Cook, and others, an act concerning legislative committees. Senate Concurrent Resolution 1611 by Senators Wagle and others, a concurrent resolution making application to the Congress of the United States to call a convention for the purpose of proposing amendments to the Constitution of the United States that impose limits on federal government.
This constitutes introduction of Senate Bill 392 through Senate Bill 393 and Senate Concurrent Resolution 1611. Messages from the House, the clerk will read.
Announcing adoption of House Concurrent Resolution 5023, a concurrent resolution providing for a joint session of the Senate and the House of Representatives for the purpose of hearing a message from the governor. House Concurrent Resolution 5023, a concurrent resolution providing for a joint session of the Senate and the House of Representatives for the purpose of hearing a message from the governor.
This constitutes introduction of HCR 1523. The chair recognizes the majority leader from Johnson County, Senator Daley.
Thank you, Madam President. I move an emergency to declare the rule suspended and HCR 5023 be adopted by voice vote.
You've heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. In compliance with HCR 5023, actually, no, it's 2053, I appoint the following senators. Escort the governor, the senator from Saline, Senator Hardy, the senator from Sedgwick, Senator Pastor Doe, to escort the Supreme Court, the senator from Cherokee, Senator Hildebrand, and the senator from Wyandotte, Senator Petty. Are there announcements? Senator from Sedgwick, Senator Sullivan.
Thank you, Madam President. Tomorrow, South Central delegation will meet for food and lunch. Topic of discussion will be workforce development. We've got a tremendous opportunity in front of us. We've got job growth on the horizon. We need to meet that opportunity. We also have a large segment of our current workforce at or near retirement. So we need to make sure our resources are devoted to the job workforce training we're going to be dealing with over the next several years. So I want to ask for your attendance. Thank you.
Senator Johnson County, Senator Graham.
Thank you, Madam President. Just a reminder that the Senate Commerce Committee dinner will be meeting tonight at 6 o'clock at the Topeka Country Club.
Further announcements? Sorry, Senator from Ford County, Senator Estes.
Thank you, Madam President. Tomorrow morning, 7 o'clock, 142 South, will be the Catholic Mission Bible Study. Thank you.
Last call. Announcements. Seeing none, the chair recognizes the majority leader from Johnson County, Senator Daley.
Thank you, Madam President. I move the Senate adjourn until 2:30 p.m. on Wednesday, February 7th, 2018.
For the motion, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. The Senate is adjourned.